Hello everyone, I'm Lucy Gunawan, the head of the data science practice at TIMi. Welcome to the first video in our tutorial series on the integration between Anatella and Azure. In this first video, I'll guide you through the initial setup inside the Azure portal to establish a seamless connection between Anatella and Azure. Anatella offers many connectors and functionalities to connect to Azure services. Here are a few examples. With Anatella, you can efficiently handle your data across various Azure services. You can manage all your data inside your OneDrive, send and receive emails, manage your data on SharePoint, manage your Azure contact list within Outlook, manage all your CRM data inside Microsoft Dynamics, and send and update analytical datasets for display in Power BI. You might have noticed that some Azure services are missing from this slide, even though it is still possible to access them with Anatella. For example, Anatella can access the data stored inside Microsoft SQL Server on Azure, inside Azure SQL Server, or inside Azure Storage. These particular services aren't listed here because they use a different connection mechanism than the standard one that we'll cover today. By the way, it is important to note that Microsoft SQL Server and Azure SQL Server are two completely different database engines with different performance characteristics. We strongly recommend using Microsoft SQL Server because it typically offers better speed, better stability, and offer performance compared to Azure SQL Server. To use one or more of these services, you need two essential pieces of information: the Azure Application ID and the Anatella Unlock Key. Getting these two parameters involves two distinct stages, typically performed by different user roles. Stage 1 involves registering a new application through the Azure portal. This setup is a one-time process. To do so, you'll need to work with an Azure administrator, someone with the ability to register new apps and grant them specific permission to access Azure services. After completing the first stage, you proceed to obtain your own personal Anatella Unlock Key. This step is taken by a user who requires access to Azure data and services via Anatella, using their own login credentials. Each different user will need a different unlock key to access his own set of files and data. If you find yourself in the role of an Azure administrator responsible for the first stage, please continue watching as I'll guide you through the process. There is also a possibility that you're wearing both hats as an administrator and a user. No worries, just keep watching. On the other hand, if you fall into the second role where you lack the necessary permission to register and grant access in Azure, here's what you should do. Simply pass this video along to your Azure administrator and kindly request their assistance in obtaining all the Azure services permissions that you require. Once that's taken care of, you'll be all set to move on to the second stage that is documented inside the second video of this series titled Getting Your Personal Anatella Unlock Key. Click here to skip to this second video. So, regardless of which role you're in, rest assured that we got you covered. Okay, let's get started. Essentially, this video is your comprehensive guide to successfully navigating and setting up the crucial first stage of the integration between Anatella and Azure. Inside this video, we'll follow a procedure in three steps. The three steps are visible here. First, we create a new app on Azure. Second, we grant all necessary permissions to access specific Azure services. Third, we get the Azure Client Secret ID. Let's start with the first step. Let's create a new app on Azure. To begin, let's navigate to the URL portal.azure.com and log in using the credential of an Azure administrator. It is crucial to note that throughout this video, we are logging to Azure as an Azure administrator, not as a regular user. Once logged in, find and click on the App Registration button. Click on the New Registration button. For the name, let's go with TIMi App. For the supported account types, make sure to leave the account in this organization directory only checked. In the Redirect URI section, select Web as the application type. Then input the following URL: https://timi.eu/azureaccess.php. You can find this URL in the video description below. Here, please be really extremely careful. Type the URL exactly as shown here, paying close attention to all the cases and all other details. Click the Register button located at the bottom of the page to proceed. You're now in the possession of the first two crucial parameters for your app. Firstly, the application client ID is displayed here, and the second, directory tenant ID, is found here. Let's copy and securely save these two parameters. Now, let's proceed to the second step, where we will grant our new app all the necessary permissions to access the required Azure services. Click on the API permission in the left menu. For simplicity in this video, we'll enable access to all the Azure services that Anatella can connect to as of April 2023. Enabling all services is recommended because if you later decide to change the available services, Azure will invalidate all the keys and tokens used by your users. This means that all the applications using these keys will stop working. If you want more details on enabling only specific services, I suggest you to read the section 5.23.27.1 in the Anatella Quick Guide. Press F1 inside your Anatella to read this guide. Additionally, it's a good practice to check the Anatella Quick Guide periodically, as we may have already updated it to include access to more Azure services. So, review the guide just in case and then return here to continue with the video, which will help you to get started and show how to get access to the most common Azure services. Now, let's dive into granting permission to access SharePoint. This process involves setting up two permissions, one for the site to access SharePoint list and the other for files to access SharePoint library or files. Let's begin by configuring the site permission. Click the plus add permission button, then select Microsoft Graph, then click on delegated permissions. In the search box, enter sites and check the box label sites.fullcontrol.all. Click on Add Permissions. You'll get a message that the permission is updated and saved. We see that the status of the sites full control all is not yet granted for TIMi. Let's click Grant Admin Consent. Once successful, you'll spot the message Grant Consent Successful at the top right corner of your browser, along with the reassuring Granted for TIMi confirmation. Next up, let's establish the file permission. Remember, this step is also crucial if you intend to grant permission for OneDrive. Let's enable permission for SharePoint file and OneDrive access. Click the plus add permission button, then select Microsoft Graph. Click on the delegated permission button. In the search box, type file and check the checkbox label files.readwrite.all. Click on add permissions. Let's enable permission for sending and receiving email using Office 365. Click the plus add permission button, then select Microsoft Graph. Click on the delegated permission button, and then in the search box, type mail and check the checkboxes label mail.readwrite and mail.send. Click on Add Permissions, then proceed to the next screen. Let's enable permission for accessing Power BI. Click the plus Add Permission button, then scroll down and select Power BI Services. Check the permissions name dataset readwrite.all and workspace readwrite.all. Click on Add Permissions, then proceed to the next screen. Let's enable permission to manage user contacts. Click the plus add permission button, then select Microsoft Graph. Click on the delegated permissions button. Then in the search box, type contact and tick the checkbox label contacts.readwrite. Click on add permissions, then proceed to the next screen. As summary, here is a quick rundown of the permissions required for each services. These three permissions mentioned here are typically granted automatically by Azure to all applications, so you should already have these permissions by default. Let's start the third and final step. To obtain the Azure client secret, follow these steps. Inside the left menu, click on the section labeled Certificates and Secrets. Click on the plus New Client Secret button. Provide a name for the description. For example, let's use main. Select the desired validity period for your Anatella Unlock Key. It is recommended to choose 24 months to avoid to losing your time to manually renew your token all the time. Click the Add button. You will get a message if the updated application credential is successful. Congratulations! Your parameter known as the Azure Client Secret value is now generated. Please remember that once generated, the Azure Client Secret value cannot be retrieved again. So, it's crucial to store this parameter securely because we'll need it again for the future. A little bit of caution here. Make sure to copy the key under the value column, as the key inside the secret ID column is not the correct value required for Anatella. There you have it. By following these steps, we have successfully obtained the three essential parameters needed to access your Azure app from Anatella. We have also granted all the necessary permission to access the required Azure services. Thank you for joining me in this tutorial. If you have any question or need future clarification on any of the topics we've covered today, feel free to leave your comments below. We highly value your feedback, and if you found this video useful, please consider giving it a thumbs up. Your support truly means a lot to us. If you're eager to explore more tutorials, engage in discussions, and access helpful tips, please subscribe to our channel. By doing so, you'll stay up to date and won't miss any of our future content. I invite you to click here to watch the next video in this series about the integration between Anatella and Azure. In the second video, we'll obtain our personal Anatella Unlock Key and we gain access to all our data from Azure. Cool! See you next time!